In this video, we're going to take a look at the control center on the Apple Watch. With the control center, we have access to various controls, much like we do with the iPhone or the iPad, or even with the Mac. We can check the status of our battery. We can put our Apple Watch into low power mode. We can turn on airplane mode. We can even use our Apple Watch as a flashlight, which is great for walking in the dark. We can also rearrange these controls and add and remove controls. Let's take a look at the control center and the various controls we have available to us on the Apple Watch. Let's go to my Apple Watch. So I'm looking at my Apple Watch. Let's first take a look at how we can access the control center. To access the control center, when you're looking at an Apple Watch face, I'm looking at my Apple Watch face. Doesn't matter which Apple Watch face you're looking at. All you need to do is just swipe up from the bottom. So I go down to the bottom here, and then I just swipe up, and I'm at my control center. To go back to the watch face, I can just swipe down from the top here, and it brings me back. Now, you may have to do that a couple of times. Sometimes it's a little tricky. Another way of getting back to the watch face or your application, I'll talk about that in a little bit, is let's go ahead and swipe up from the bottom here. Another way of closing the control center is by tapping on the side button. This is typically how I will do it. So I push in on the side button, we're back at my Apple Watch face. Now it works a little bit different when we're in an app. Let's go over to my weather app here. When I'm in an app, what I need to do is tap and hold or long press down at the bottom here. When I long press, you're going to see there's a gray bar. When that gray bar shows, I swipe up. So we can't just swipe up. We have to long press and then swipe up. But to close it, it works basically the same way. I can swipe down from the top here, or we can use my favorite method, go over to the side button, press it, and it closes it. We can also rearrange these controls. How do we do that? Well, we first have to go into our control center. So I'm going to go back to my watch face here, and I just swipe up from the bottom. And if I wanted to rearrange these, what I do is I scroll up. I can either just swipe up to scroll, or what I typically do is use the digital crown. So I just turn this. We can see all the different controls. We'll take a look at these in more detail shortly. But if we go all the way down to the bottom, you're going to see Edit. When I tap on Edit, it goes into the jiggly mode, and we're all familiar with this. And then from here, what I can do is I can tap and hold to drag them around. So I can just move these controls where I want. So if I have a control that I use quite a bit, what I can do is just drag it up towards the top and place it at the top. You're going to see that we can also remove some of these controls. Not all of the controls, but some of them. You're going to see that we have a little red minus here by some of them. When I tap on that minus, what it does is it removes it. Let's go ahead and tap on it again. So I just removed two controls. Where does it move them to? Well, if we scroll up, you're going to see at the very bottom, when we're in that jiggly mode, we have our controls here. They're under More. To add them back in, all I have to do is just tap on it. Let's go ahead and tap on the green plus, and it adds it back in. Now, if I wanted to rearrange these again, I want to have Focus or Do Not Disturb up towards the top. All I have to do is just drag this up, and I place it up towards the top. And now what I need to do is just scroll back down to the bottom, and then we tap on Done. So I tap on Done, and now it saves my controls. Now let's take a look at these controls in a little more detail. I'm actually going to go to Apple's website so we can actually see how this works. So what we're going to do, instead of looking at this on my Apple Watch, we're going to look at this on my MacBook Air with a short description. Now you're going to see that we do have these icons here, and these icons will match what I'm going to talk about. So let's go over to my Mac here. And you're going to see I have all of these different controls. What I did is I searched for Control Center on the Apple Watch. I just searched for Control Center Apple Watch. So our first control here that we have available to us is for cellular connection. Now this will only show if you have an Apple Watch with cellular connection. And what you're able to do is turn this on or off. We also have Wi-Fi. What we can do is we can disconnect from our Wi-Fi. We also have Schooltime. This is turned off by default. I don't know if you saw it when I was at my Apple Watch. This was at the very bottom and turned off. What this will do is this will turn on Schooltime. This is for managed Apple Watches only, so you may not see this, but it'll turn on Do Not Disturb for specific apps. Again, you may not see this. This is for managed Apple Watch. I work at a school, so I'm playing around with this. So that's why I have it on my Apple Watch. Now below that, we have Ping Your iPhone. When you tap on this, what it'll do is it'll play sound on your iPhone so you can find it. Now the iPhone doesn't have to be nearby the Apple Watch. It has to be within Bluetooth range. So if you left it somewhere, it is not going to ping it. You'll have to use Find My for that. But if you're at home and you can't find your Apple Watch, all you have to do is just tap on this in the control center. Your Apple Watch will make a sound, your iPhone will make a sound, and then you can find it. My wife uses this on a daily basis, I believe. We also have our battery percentage. We can see how strong our battery is. And when you tap on this, you're able to go into low power mode. Below that, we have silence. What this will do is this will silence all notifications so your Apple Watch will not make any sound. I typically will leave this on. We can lock our Apple Watch with a passcode. And then we have theater mode. This is great for when you're at a theater watching a movie. If you have an Apple Watch that is always on, or if it is not always on, you know that when you raise your wrist, what it'll do is the display will come on. Well, what this will do is this will prevent that display from coming on. So how do you check the time when you're in theater mode? Well, all you have to do is just press in on the digital crown. When the movie is done, you can turn this back off and then your Apple Watch will always be on, or it'll turn on when you raise your wrist. We can also make ourselves available for walkie-talkie. This basically turns your Apple Watch into a walkie-talkie with other Apple Watch users. We have our Do Not Disturb. Tap on this and we can turn on Do Not Disturb. I will actually use this in conjunction with theater mode when I'm watching a movie. I don't want any notifications and I do not want my Apple Watch to turn on. So I usually would turn both of these on here. You can turn on and off a personal focus, which is a modified Do Not Disturb. We also have work focus. If you're using a work focus, you can turn that on and off. You can turn on and off sleep focus if you're using sleep. Now, the way that these work is you tap on this and then these will come up as options. We also have a flashlight. I will use this when I'm walking at dark. You turn this on and then your Apple Watch will shine a white light. The whole screen will turn white. And if you swipe to the left or right, you can actually have a blink, which is great for walking at night. Just swipe down to turn it back off. We have airplane mode. We all know what that does. We also have water lock. If you're going swimming, you may want to turn this on. This will prevent any accidental taps on the screen. Water can accidentally tap complications, and your Apple Watch may do stuff when you're not actually wanting it to do anything. So what you'll want to do is turn this on. To turn it off, what you do is you press in on the digital crown, hold it there, and then it'll turn it off and it'll clean out the speaker from any water. We also have choose audio output. So if you have AirPods, you can choose your audio output and select your AirPods. We have our headphone volume. If you're using AirPods again, you can check your headphone volume. We can change our text size of the Apple Watch. We also have accessibility shortcuts that we can turn on and off. And then our last one here is turn announcements on and off. Now this depends on if you're using AirPods that have announcements. So some of these controls will be dependent on what other devices you have. So I have AirPods Pro. This is an option that I can turn on and off. If I didn't have AirPods Pro, I would not be able to do this. So again, depending on which options you have or which devices you have, you may see some of these options. Now also, some of these options are dependent on the Apple Watch. And again, let's go back over to my Apple Watch. You're going to see that when you're looking at the Apple Watch, it's the same icons. So let's go over to my battery. I mentioned we can turn on low power mode. How do we do that? Well, all I have to do is just tap on this. We can see it's at 93%. I tap on it, and from here, what I'm able to do is turn on low power mode. So we have more options when we tap on a control. With some of the controls, in airplane mode, all I can do is just turn it on and off. But if I go to focus here, I'm able to turn on do not disturb or sleep. So that is our control center on the Apple Watch. As you can see, it's much like the control center on the iPhone or the iPad. We have various controls. We can rearrange them. We can even remove them. Some of the controls will be dependent on what options you have or what devices you have or what Apple Watch you have. And some controls, you just tap on them to turn them on and off, or other ones, what you'll need to do is tap on it and then select what you want to do from there. You have more options. So that's the control center on the Apple Watch.